seems I think I'm playing a Yankee Panky with these fish. I throw it in there and yank them out. Well, good morning, folks. We got a beautiful fall morning here in central Missouri. Got some sun in the sky. We have cool temperatures. Gonna see if the crappie and bluegill are active, and they should be after we've had quite a bit of rain recently and we've had a lot of cool nighttime temperatures. How is this conflict going to be resolved? I guess she wins. Sorry, buddy.
Some interesting water temperature. Water stained. About 2.5 feet of visibility. And I'm going to be throwing some chasey kind of stuff. And also some weighty kind of things for the lazy fish. Tell your little cousin to come out. I came in the other day from doing yard work, and my wife had cooked something. I said, that smells good. What is that? She said, well, I used the Ninja Foodie, and I cooked some of those red eyes. Well, she meant red ear, of course, but that's all right. Anyway, if you haven't tried a Ninja air fryer, it really works good on just about everything that you want to fry, and for fish it works really good. The only thing I dare throw up in these sticks is weedless, so I'm using a Finesse BulletZ jig head. Now, Mr. B, you know you are not a bluegill. Pretty nice, Mr. B. Probably should have netted you, buddy. Nice bass. Very healthy. I remarked my measuring board. That first mark there is on 9. That's for bluegill. And that second mark is on 15. That's for bass. 15 is about the typical keeper size allowable in the state of Missouri. But I don't keep the bass anyway, so what difference does it make? I'm going to guess 14 and a half. So you surprised me, Mr. B. You're not only fat, but you're also between 15 and a quarter and 15 and a half. Wow. Impressive. I know there's big bass in this pond as well. It's nice to see one of the better ones every now and then. So I'm messing around back in those sticks. And that's where a Finesse BulletZ comes in real handy. Catch you later. There's another one. Just threw it in those sticks. You guys do realize that I'm getting tired, right, from all this weightlifting? Mr. B, I'm sorry, sir. Nice and cool. But I'm not looking for you guys today. I'm looking for the Mr. P's. See ya. Bank runners. BRB. BRB, bank running, Mr. B. Pretty good one. These burbs are just stacked up over there along the bank. Something else to catch them like that, isn't it? Burbs are on the bank, that's where you fish for them. Christmas. And burb. When I'm casting this micro chatterbait, I'm giving it a little tug to make sure that blade is spinning. Healthy. Persistence. Nice thing about you little guys is next year you'll be big guys. Sometimes I think I'm playing Yankee Panky with these fish. I throw it in there and yank them out. You have done real good today, Mr. Micro Chatterbait. Pretty nice. Just shy of 15. I enjoyed playing Yankee Panky with you, buddy. Well, we're getting close to terminating this operation. Thank everybody for going along today. this was a heck of a lot of fun. Today wound up being a day of the bees. That's another pretty nice one. So we had the micro chatterbait and a shortened hulu stick. That'll make Lorraine happy. All right, we'll just call it 15. Those two lures did all the work today. I think I caught one bass on a spinnerbait. That's about it. Thank you, sir. Catch you later. Thanks again, folks, for coming along. Hope you enjoyed the show. Learned quite a bit today. Today I learned that the water temperature, which was between 65 and 66 degrees, for some reason moved the bass in on the banks. The crappie and the bluegill were nowhere to be found. So that was an interesting thing to learn today. So as Mr. Wise Old Owl would say, from our house to your house, God bless.